Now, your solution may be a little bit different than ours, so let's take this into account when walking through this code. Now, you'll notice that the full range of z-indexes aren't actually used inside of grids. We allow, for instance, a z-index value to be between 0 and 100, but in reality, we only use about 10 or 11 of them. But the values we do use are actually scattered across the number line. You may have a bunch of them in the range of 20, some of them in 50, and then some of them in 90. The naive approach to this solution would be to actually create a simple for loop that would represent and count through each of the z-index values, searching through the array for any entity that has that value and rendering it. Rather than wasting the CPU cycles reiterating over the list, Grits employs a bucketized method. What we do is if an entity is visible given our view rec, we'll actually go through and place the entity in a bucket based on its z-index value, much like the hash table we used before with the entity class map. So if we find that the z-index for a given entity already exists in our array, then we simply go ahead and add that entity to our array. If we find that the z-index for an entity does not already exist in our array, then we go ahead and create a bucket for that z-index so that future entities that have that same value can be sorted appropriately. Once that's done, we go ahead and assign this entity to its proper z-index bucket. Afterwards, we have a simple sorting function that will sort the buckets by their z-index value and then iterate over the buckets, drawing each entity in turn.